Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Summer solstice on June 21st. Okay, this is, hands down, the easiest way to learn your way around the summer sky. Wait, actually it will require hands up, because you'll be using your hands to measure angular distance in the sky. Check out this video here for more on that. Ready? Face north. Turn left slightly and notice the recognizable shape of the Big Dipper, or plow. These seven stars are mostly second magnitude and are visible from most any light polluted areas. Last week we looked at how to find Polaris from the pointer stars in the Big Dipper. Continue that line from the pointer stars through Polaris. From about 10 to 30 degrees out from there, in this direction, is Cepheus the King, a largely dim constellation, and for many areas only 2.5 magnitude Aldebaran will be visible. Now from there, drop towards the horizon. The W shape of Cassiopeia the Queen is here, and although three of her brighter stars are also second magnitude, her low elevation may make her hard to see. However, the summer Milky Way flows right through Cassiopeia. Remember that. We'll return to her in a bit. Back to the Big Dipper. Now take your hand and trace 30 degrees from the handle an arc to the fourth brightest star in the sky, Arcturus, of Boötes the Herdsman. One more 30 degrees hop, and you can speed on to Spica in Virgo. This is the 16th brightest star in the sky. So far, most of these are easy to find, right? Next, a few more bright stars, but some true summer stars and constellations as well. And now this week's dark sky fact. Globe at Night kicks off their June observing season on Tuesday the 17th, and it runs through the 26th of this month. So get out there, observe, and submit your observations to globeatnight.org so we can track light pollution together. This year, a couple of planetary interlopers make for some additional sights in the south. Mars and Saturn are in the Virgo and Libra regions. More directly south, and low to the horizon, is 17th brightest star Antares, a similar color as Mars, but this red giant star is at the heart of Scorpius. For observers at lower northern latitudes, 1.6 magnitude Shaula may be visible near the horizon, close to the stinger of the scorpion. And just to the east is where the other side of the summer Milky Way is, and Sagittarius the Archer largely fills this space. It has a number of not only second magnitude stars, but lots of deep sky targets to observe too. Most observers tend to look for the teapot asterism here. But what is along the arm of our galaxy here, between Sagittarius and Cassiopeia? Trace a long arc up and over from the Archer to the Queen. The first bright star along this horizon-to-horizon arc will be Altair, 12th brightest star, which is the eagle eye of Aquila. Continuing another almost 40 degrees finds Deneb, the powerhouse star at the tail of Cygnus the Swan. Between these two stars is a huge swath of our galaxy, and it lies towards overhead, making it perfect for sweeping with binoculars. But more directly towards the zenith, and just beyond the Milky Way's plane, is 5th brightest Vega in Lyra the Harp. These three stars form what is often known as the summer triangle, three bright stars of three different summer constellations that light the way to many other deep sky objects and double stars of this warm season. But what about some of the dimmer constellations, where other small telescope targets may be found? Use Vega as a reference. Between it and Antares in the south lies the large constellation Ophiuchus that splits the constellation Serpens in half. From Vega towards Arcturus are the large and dim Hercules, plus the smaller and also dim Corona Borealis. From Vega to Kochab is much of the head and upper end of Draco, the dragon. In fact, two or three of the brighter head stars may be seen here. And finally, circling back towards the summer triangle, the area between Vega and Altair, and Altair to Deneb, is home to both diminutive Sagitta the Arrow, and very dim and unimpressive Vulpecula the Fox. But the fox holds a clever secret to finding a wonderful stellar remnant. Check out these summer stars this week with the moon out of the way, and get familiar with the bright stars and constellation shapes. We'll delve into these areas for deep sky objects over the next few months. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.